I've spent so much time in the container, and now I'm pretty sure that I understand everything about it after all these months doing tests and experiments. But there was this one thing that I couldn't really figure out, and that was making my design responsive even on a desktop. As I explained in my last grid video, you want your designs to be responsive on tablet and mobile, and then I proposed that we should work in pixels with these specific values in the 1140 grid, because on a desktop you want a fixed width, because otherwise the text will become too wide. So I was like, let's just use pixels on desktop and percentages on tablet and mobile. But there were some people that said like, hey Reno, yeah, but some people have a smaller screen and then your design doesn't really work. So I thought, yes, they have a point. I want my designs to be fully responsive. But now I have finally found a way to use both a fixed width for your main container on desktop while also keeping it responsive when the screen is smaller. Look at this. It's fixed now and now it becomes smaller and then it wraps perfectly to tablet and mobile. Absolutely beautiful. I'm pretty proud that I now have found this and it just works really nicely. This also, I think, works the same in Bricks and in Webflow, because they also use the flexbox. Actually, any tool that uses the flexbox, it should work like this. So for people that have no experience in the container yet, the beginner-friendly tutorials will come. I will release them when Elementor finally puts the container out of beta and by default in the whole plugin, because right now they're still changing it and I don't want my videos to be outdated within a month. So let's dive into it and let me know if you spot any mistakes in my approach. Okay, so let's say that I want to create this design. It has two texts over here and then three boxes or containers over here. So here I have a container for these two texts and I have one container with three containers in it. And this container is set on, by default, on no wrap. It's not active, but by default, it's on no wrap. So if you add containers, it will automatically determine its width and that's what you want. You don't have to work with pixels at all, because if you know that your main container is on 1120, which your design also is, then you know that each container is 360 and that's exactly the same as your design. And this is all really nice, but what if you have two rows? Well, then you could be like, okay, let's just duplicate this section and then we have two rows. But then this creates a problem on tablet, because since the first three one are in a container, you get a gap over here and that doesn't look very good. So now you need to work with wrapping. You enable wrapping by clicking on the container and then clicking on wrap. But now these containers, if you don't give them any width, they will go to the max width. So here you have to determine how wide these boxes should be. And if two boxes both can fit on one row, then Elementor will do it. But what kind of numbers do you use here? So here we could use my template and just be like, okay, we want three columns, so 360 in pixels in width. So you go to your column, you go to pixels, 360, you copy that to the other ones, as you see perfectly. And now if you duplicate this one two times, we have six containers in one container, and on tablets you don't have the gaps anymore, which is what you want. But as you can imagine, with pixels it is not responsive, because from this point on it doesn't really look that good. And then it already wraps over here even though we're not on tablet mode yet, because now we're on tablet mode, you see. So this whole space, that doesn't look very good. So let's say that you put this first container on grow, nothing happens. But if you decrease its size, it stays the same. If you increase it a bit, then it becomes two columns, as you can see. So what is going on here? So let's start with one container again. So now this first container is 500 pixels wide and it's set on grow. So it will be at least 500 pixels and then it will grow. So then if we start to duplicate this, now as you can see, it creates two boxes. If we duplicate it again, this one will be 100% width. But this first box is a lot wider than 500. It's actually 550. Which is the exact width of just six columns on a 12 column grid. And don't forget that Elementor also calculates the space in between over here in order to decide if it reaches the 100%. So let's say that we put this one on 50%, what would happen then? 50%, because that makes a lot of sense. It still wraps. That doesn't make any sense, but that is because 50 plus 50% plus the 20 pixels in between is more than 100, and then it will grow to the end. So if you put this at a little bit lower, let's say 45, and this one also on 45, then these two will be 550. So they are not actually 45%, they are 45% plus what they can grow in this one row. But since 45% plus 45 is 90, and 20 pixels in between is not the 10% left in this whole box, that means that we haven't reached the 100%, and therefore two boxes will stay on one row. I hope that this makes sense. So I did a lot of calculations and I tried to make a whole grid. So let me explain what's going on here. So let's say that we want a tree column layout or a tree container layout like this. And you want it to wrap, right? So why did I use 25% here? Well, 25% is the minimum number you can use in order to get three columns. Why? 25 times 4 is gonna be 100. So 25 times 3 plus the space in between, which is in this container just a default 20 pixels, will not fit 4 boxes. Because 25 times 4 plus the space is not possible. So that's why you actually need to use 25 in order to get a 3-column layout. I hope that that makes sense. Let's go to another example, this one. 50 doesn't work because 50 plus 50 plus space in between is more than 100, which is what I just showed you. So why this number? Well, what is 100 divided by 3? It's 33.333. So that's why the minimum number you can use is 33.3. So to make it easy, I've just used 35. But why did I go on the lower end, right? Well, why not go with 45 over here? Well, that is because of that space that you need when the screen is smaller. Because if you would work in pixels here, then at some point, then it would probably break. And with these numbers, this seems to work fine. And on tablet and mobile, you're working with percentages anyway. So working with percentages and never having to touch pixels again in Elementor is kind of great, you know? Oh, and the third reason is that these numbers are just easy to remember, right? 35, 25, 20. And here on tablet, it says 25 because on a tablet, 6 columns is way too much. So on a tablet, you want, at some point, you want 3, I think, from 6 to 3, that makes sense. So this layout with 3 columns should be 25 in the same way as 3 columns on a desktop is 25, right? Because 4 times 25 plus gap cannot occur, therefore it becomes 3. So at some point you will have these numbers just in your mind, then it becomes really easy. 2 columns is always 35. 3 columns is always 25. 4 columns is always 20. It's so easy, I'm so happy with this. So let me show you the settings. So this container is on 1120 because that's what I explained in my last grid video. The actual width of the content in the 1140 grid is 1120. It doesn't stretch to the 1140 width. So my main container is on 1120, but everything is on percentages. So at some point it will scale. So let's just go to, for example, the laptop over here. I've added some extra breakpoints, which you can manage over here. So here it's still the same values on tablets in landscape mode as well. Then when you go to the tablet in portrait mode, this will become 100%. On desktop, this layout, let's just go back one step, was 3 columns. So in most cases, you want 2 columns on a tablet. This one becomes 35, because again, 35 will always create 2 columns, and so on. 3 columns, always 25. As you can see, it's so easy to implement. And this part on desktop was 6 containers next to each other, so that means that the content is small, so maybe you could fit 2 on a mobile phone, so that's why I've used 35 over here. And even for the people that do not agree with me and say that I shouldn't pick the 1140 grid because on bigger screens, that's not good, you want everything scalable, well, what's great about this trick is that this also works with percentages. So you can change this whole layout to, let's say, 80%. And then it still works because let's just test it. Gonna click update. See? Because all of the inside containers have percentages and now the outside box container has that as well. So even if you would like your whole website to be stretched, because with some designs that's kind of cool, you can use these numbers as well. And I've even tested this on a super big 4K screen, as you can see. And these numbers that you see over here work on a big screen like that as well. But like I've said, for most websites, I don't use that. I just use the default fixed width because otherwise the text box just become too wide and then people have to read like this. Most people don't like that, and I think that's why Elementor also just gives us the 1140 grid as default, because that's best for most websites. So okay, now we have covered the wrapping with grow, which is kind of awesome. But you have to understand that these numbers only work when all of the boxes in the row are the same size, because they all grow with the same rate. That is how the grow feature works. But if you have something like this, where this first part takes up 5 columns and then this one takes up 7, then these numbers don't work. So if you scroll down on this page, you can see this part. By the way, if you want this whole page as a download, I can give it to you if you want to, so you can see it for yourself, how it works, and maybe even copy and paste things to your own projects. You can get this whole page template by going to the landing page, and then I will send it to you via email. But if you already want to use it now, make sure that the container is activated on your website, which you can do in the settings. So let's go back to my design. So this part is 5 columns wide, and then this one is 7 columns wide. Okay, so here we have that layout. How did I calculate this number? Well, this is very simple. A 5 column element in the 1140 grid is 455 pixels wide. Divide that by 1120, and here you have it, 40.63. That's why you see this number over here. Again, we want to use percentages, not pixels. So let me show you how this works. I'm going to copy this. So here I have a similar layout. There's one container. This container is on row. This widget has no width, and this widget has no width. And this one is super wide because there's a lot of content in it. And this one is just as wide, as much space as it needs, as you can see. So now you can go to the advanced tab, go to the width, go to custom, and paste that number. So now it should break at the same word as in our design file, as you can see. That is how that works. This is 455 in width. Let's calculate that. It's not 455. So what is happening here? Well, we have to put an element next to it. So let's just put this one, as explained in my guide. Here it should say grow. So let's put that one on grow. But then it also doesn't change. And why is that? Well, the grow feature only works if the element has some minimum width. So let's just try that. I want to give it some width, at least something. So let's say just 1%, right? So now that doesn't really work, because this element, which is 40% plus 1%, is not enough, because this element is 25. So that means that the container will try to stick it on one row. So we need to make this wider, because again, it will take the minimum, as you can see, and then at the first percentage or first pixel that it doesn't fit anymore in the 100%, it will grow. So here we will need at least this one. And for this element, let's see if it's now the size that we want, which should be 455. It's still not the same size, because you need to use this feature. And this feature says it will be 45% no matter what happens, because the flexbox is flexible. So it will try to keep all the elements flexible. But if you enable this option, then it will keep this size no matter what. And now let's see if it's the right size. It's still not the right size. And that is because our main container is still on 1140, because I haven't set it up on this website. So let's just put it on 1120, and let's now calculate it again. And now it's 455. So now we have the exact same design over here as in our design. But of course, these percentages are based on the 1140 grid. So let's say that you want to create a website with the 1260 grid, a little bit wider. Then you need to use other numbers, which you can calculate by just dividing this number with 1230. But I like to stick to the 1140 grid, and then maybe only change the gutter, increase that. But since we're working with percentages, that also works, right? So it doesn't change when the gutter changes. So you can use these numbers. Let me show you over here. If you would increase this to 30, it still works. It's just awesome. So the only thing that isn't that pretty is this part, but I think that this is the closest to perfection, at least from what I understand. And I've already spent so much time in the container. If you think that I can do this part better, let me know. Or maybe I've even made a mistake over here, also let me know. But if you guys also think that this is the perfect way to work, then I can create tutorials about it, and I will create frameworks. I can include that in the course, because I'm gonna launch an Elementor Pro course soon, which I'm super excited about. So yeah, that's it. the final piece to understanding the container for me. And you could say that I made some mistakes with this approach, but there's one thing you can say, and that is that I'm not well prepared for the container. Okay, guys, thanks for watching. I hope that you liked this super, super in-depth hardcore video. That's at least how I see it. I know it's not beginner friendly, but hey, not every video can be for beginners, right? Thank you for watching. Let me know what you think down below.